Oh, thank you. Yeah. Oh, good.
Yeah, good run, but I got sunstroke. It's very hard to run after that.
Uh-huh.
But I ran. Looked pretty terrible, but I made it. 20K.
The Sacred Run started this year and continued to be an annual event. The Sacred Run has been taking place in different parts of the world since 1988. The run carries with it the message of the sacred relationship of all life and of the need to preserve creation. Another aim of this run is to deepen the understanding between different cultures. In the end of 1993, around 50 participants from all over the world took part in a sacred run covering a total of more than 10,000 kilometers through Australia and New Zealand. From Sydney through Brisbane, Townsville, Alice Springs, Adelaide, Melbourne, and then back to Sydney. In New Zealand, the sacred run took place from Auckland through Gisborne, Wellington, Tukwete, and then back to Auckland. In the year 2000, the Sacred Run took place once again in Australia. After completing a total of 200 to 300 kilometers a day, the runners were welcomed as usual by the Aborigines in Australia and by the Maori in New Zealand.
I believe too that the white population today don't seem to understand the symbol of our tradition. And sometimes they would ask the question, what dream story is all about? Dream story is something that when a person dies, his spirit goes away, that's all. And yet a lot of people don't seem to understand that. And that's all I have to say, but I want to thank the friends from all over the world to come here and march right through Australia in this sacred run. And to me, I hold it very dear to my heart. Thank you very much.
Oh,
declared that it would be necessary for indigenous people to return to the ceremonies, return to their rituals, return and strengthen ceremonies. And so we began to take this message. We decided that we would revive the old tradition of going from one village to the next, running. And even though that we carry all of our backpacks and all of our sleeping gear, tents, food, we use trucks and vans and buses, the running continues. We have run, this is our fifth day from Sydney. We have run every kilometer from here to Sydney. In the past 15 years, they've run 34,000 miles. And the only message that we carry with us is that there is a relationship between human beings and Mother Earth that should prevail over any other land policy in this world. That should be the only understanding. Well, I know that it's not, but that's not our mission, to question the policies of state, nation, community. Only that to remind people of that relationship, that basic relationship that began so many hundreds of thousands of years ago, perhaps millions of years ago. That relationship that has allowed you and I to survive to this point.
Landscape,
you like this?
Yeah, I love it. This outback, I mean, I'm from Western New South Wales, so it's the flat country, the dry, it's like the heart of Australia. It's where the beautiful parts and the harsh, but not hard. Australia is a country you must respect. Must respect it, because she just, that's, you must, that's all. And this part is where the heart is, so it's like the soft parts, like the coast and things like that, they're part of Australia, but they're like the nursery. This is the real stuff out here, the real Australia. And she doesn't show her beauty very quickly. It takes a long time to understand and appreciate Australia, because it's a very slow, subtle country. There's all the grasses are really beautiful, but you don't see them at first. And the trees, they're like, the grasses have the most amazing flowers on them, with 7 or 8 different structures in one flower. And the dry times are like the country sleeping, and it's preparing and waiting for, and white man wants to farm it and wants to grow things on it all the time, gets really hypo and really stressed out when there's no rain, but it's part of the Australian way. And it's up to us to accept it and to learn how to be with it. But if you look around, you can see everywhere we've been, the country is really tired. It needs some loving. It needs caring. It needs that connection. There's too many of us who are too caught up, me in organizing and in jobs and things. Too caught up, so we lose that sense of being part of the landscape and our direction and what's important. It becomes futile, or we work for what? For nothing. For money. And what's money? I mean, you need it, but it doesn't come from in here.
Hey!
Welcome you here. Thank you, brother. I'm your oldest brother. You are my youngest brother.
You like that? Keep
come.
Going,
going. Se pa unirite po tangata mo te koe ua e te moe. Rahia te ki. Ke ia wai te ko. Hei herenga tangata, hei herenga wairua. Hei pupu kaua tuki roto te whatu mano a te ngāko kua tau nei. Hei tauranga here, hei tauranga tangata, hei hurunga, hei taura here, hei utu, hei utu.
Thank you.
Pero menos va a caer uno.
and meet the chief. I don't like the way you said to meet him.
For mankind is to understand one another, to understand different cultures, go up and speak to people. Because you can't speak the lingo, you don't turn away and, "I don't understand him." You go up, shake his hand and say, "I'm your friend. He speak to you. Me want to know your culture. Me tell you my culture, you tell me. And then we be friends." Because, like the bar face say, the world is one planet, you know, the one earth. There's one big one earth, and all mankind are the citizens what live on this one earth. And they all different cultures. And they get together as one family and laugh and talk and be friends with one another and break the barriers of racism, prejudice, and everybody be brother and sister. Yeah. Make everybody happy. Don't fight, be happy. Yeah. That's the best way.
Spirit needs to flow. You and I. tummy one and sing the theme. You have eyes you cannot see, for you have ears that cannot hear. Spirit flowing down on you. Spirit flowing down on you.
Don't worry, I can slide in.
Why must be me? Why must be more? Taking and giving and holding on.
Dean, the finish is only about 500 meters if you want to go ahead.
My,
remembering that we owe it to ourselves.
Hey.
We need to do the things.
Is that alright?
You're right.
Is that a true?
And as we walk this path, we know it's narrow.
Finish!
But as we join together, it becomes wider.
It can't stop!
Wider down the ocean. That it becomes higher, higher than the sky. I just wanna ride, hold on to the roughness in my life.
Thank you.
Thank you.
When we look at the earth, the pollution, and the rivers and the streams, and 100 years from now, they'll say, depending on what we do today, they'll say, what did our grandfathers and grandmothers, what did they do about this? They'll say, well, my grandfather, Jason, ran 50K one time, straight away, just to make it aware that all life is sacred. Ran with a message. And that we did do something.
There's 66 million sheep, and there's more sheep than land. Now they're selling my land to the Asians, and even they're selling the airspace. And I am saying that that culture and that has to stop. I was born the eighth child in a family of 15. There were 7 older and 7 younger, and I lived in a beautiful world of the Maori people, not much money, no clothes, and we were free. We ate white bait like porridge and had a wonderful time. And I lived at a time when people and children were important, when there was food aplenty, and I lived on this land. And we were poor in money, but rich in love and understanding. So I had a family life that can't be matched in this world today. I lived in the old times.
All I can just say this in Pākehā. Welcome in the mighty Lord name of our great Saviour, who created heaven and earth, who created mankind, who created all race. I greet you in his name. I greet you on to this valley, to our Tūpunapale. I say welcome, welcome, welcome. Oh, bless us all. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa.
Tahiru a tolu fa.
Tahiru a tolu fa.
Awa. Awa. Awa.
Māori culture today, I'm very frightened that it's out there. It's something in the wardrobe that you put on. And that's what it's become. It's something you learn at school. You can't learn a word properly until it becomes permeate your life. And people are learning instant Māori, become instant chief. And they haven't done the groundwork, eh? It's a lifestyle. Māori culture is a lifestyle. It's not a few carvings and everyone go back to the house. Māori culture is about tātou tātou. Tātou tātou means sharing. It means taking only enough for yourself and then sharing with the rest. So if we're all paddling a canoe, everyone paddled their best. And if there's someone who's too sick and can't paddle, they don't have to paddle. Right? The marais are empty. They go home from the marae and no one is there. And the marae used to be our It used to be our art gallery. It used to be our museum. It used to be the place where we live every day. It used to be our place of work, and it used to be our university. It used to be our place of play. It used to be where we're born and where we're buried. And we don't own it. And so it's everything that the European has in one little place. And that you're proud to be in this place. We bring our children up there because, for me, I have no faith in the system. I don't believe the system is sustainable.
Have a bit of a garden there. See, I'm growing some, trying to grow some wheat. Yeah, just plain.
You make all your own food? You don't have to buy something?
Oh yeah, you got to buy something, but I make all my own bread, butter, cheese. Make all that.
Uh-huh.
And I don't have to. It's just because I like to do it.
Naturally.
That's right. And I get a lot of fun out of doing it. There's my own bread. See, I make all my own bread.
Wow.
There's my own bread. I'll show you my cheese. I just made these the other day. They're not ready yet. But I make all my own cheese. There's cheese. There's a smaller one I made.
The American Indians, they say ho instead of kia ora.
Yeah. But I reckon, you know, as I say, it's a lot of fun. The last lot of cheese I made, even the pigs wouldn't eat. But you know, what the hell? I must strike it right one day.
You sure?
Strike it right. Yeah. Oh yes. Now you fellas take sugar and milk? All take milk?
I'm plenty of milk, no sugar, thank you.
Yeah, I'll say something. It's okay, sir. How much you have done, Craig, now?
There's 10K left, I guess. 90.
90K you were running?
Yeah.
It looks like after 10. Was not hard for you?
My legs are feeling it.
You feel your legs?
Huh?
You feel your legs?
Yeah.
Oh, I think so.
It becomes too hard to carry.
You sure you're not crazy?
I don't know.
To go 100Ks?
Thank you.
I think everybody in the world should be able to walk within walking distance from their house, should be able to go through a bit of pure native bush, belong to that country. Never mind the exotic stuff, I love it. But there should be a bit of pure bush with in that bush should be the animals that belong to that country and the birds that belong to that country, and they should be protected. We owe it to them. If we keep going on greedily like we are, this everything will finish.